host to Focus Event and Entertainment, WrestleMania Kickoff.
Talk about this match. When it comes to subtle matches that we're going to see here tonight. This one's going to be at the top of the list of the most personal. We've seen what's gone down between these two gentlemen over the last several weeks. I talked to AJ Styles earlier today on The Bump. I've never seen so much intensity. This man apologized to the WWE Universe live on The Bump, saying, "Hey guys, I'm sorry for what you're about to have to witness me do to Edge tonight."
Well, listen, Edge is bringing this on himself, and I think we need to be real about this. This is who Edge is. You know, sometimes when someone shows you who they are, believe them, right? Edge, time and time again, has been the ultimate opportunist. So he came back under this cloak of wanting to have all these matches with these other great superstars. The truth is, Edge just wants to beat people up.
Yeah,
that's what he's been doing to AJ.
Beth Phoenix's wife is taking to Twitter each and every week, curious as to what she's seeing. She's stunned by the developments with Edge, so I'm not sure it's exactly him.
No, but it's always been in him. Yeah, sure, new guy, married to Beth, kids, etc. You don't see it all the time. But this is Edge, book. You've seen it.
Yeah. The clock is ticking, man. Edge is a veteran. He's a grizzled veteran. He knows all about winning. I mean, 31 championships overall. Edge is a guy that's not going to hesitate as far as trying to in your career. That's why I say AJ style, he cannot hesitate as far as pulling the trigger in the ring with Edge, because there again, only a blink of an eye, bam, it could be over.
Well, that's true. You know, I couldn't help but smile when I heard AJ apologize to the WWE Universe for what he's about to do to Edge. And I smiled again just a minute ago when I heard Edge looking in that camera saying, "You think you know me? You think you know me, AJ?" I don't think any of us know the AJ. Well, don't know any of us know the Edge that we're going to see tonight. I think AJ is in store for a rude awakening.
Wow. Well, you guys talk about this being personal. I beg to differ. This is business. Edge knows.
Right.
Not to AJ. Maybe to Edge it's business. No, AJ it's as personal as it gets.
This is business. Edge knows I got to get in this kid head. I got to ruffle his feathers a little bit. I got to make him think about certain things coming into a situation like this. This is business. Trust me.
That's the veteran in him you're talking
exactly
about.
Exactly my point.
It's interesting that you said that, though, because AJ said earlier that Edge has been trying to get into his head, and AJ said he absolutely has. He said he has not thought about one other thing other than Edge in the weeks leading up to this. What Edge is trying to do, but AJ is embracing it. And I think we're going to see a very dangerous and unpredictable AJ tonight.
But isn't that exactly what Edge wanted? He wanted the Bulldog. He said, "I want that AJ Styles." Well, guess what? You got him now.
How do you explain what happened, Gus? How do you explain what happened on that day in the ring when Edge, it was like a flick of a switch, and all of a sudden we saw a completely unrecognizable Edge from what we've
That's
seen?
That's what he can do.
You know what? I can answer that. Edge saw himself in AJ Styles once upon a time. That right there in itself, that's a huge, huge threat. I got to put this guy down, and I got to do it right now, and I got to do it quick.
All right, around the table real quickly, let's get quick predictions on this match. Edge or AJ Styles? Peter?
I'm going with the phenomenal one, AJ Styles.
All right.
I fear for AJ Styles' safety, to be honest. I've seen Edge backstage, and I've steered clear of him. I'm saying Edge.
Edge is definitely has the moniker, the rated R superstar, for a reason. And I got to go with Edge.
He says, "You don't know me." Tonight, we are going to get to know Edge for real. And I'm going with Edge.
All right, everyone. Well, listen, the WrestleMania kickoff show is delivered to you in part by Papa John's. Order Papa John's Epic Stuffed Crust Pizza now on the app or at papajohns.com. All right, everyone, we've got lots more kickoff coming up. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. That's right, guys. The biggest WrestleMania match of all time. Winner take all championship unification. By the way, these are the only two men to ever defeat The Undertaker. Little fact right there. And so happened, The Undertaker predicted what was going to happen in this match. Let's take a look. Wow. Hearing from the brand new WWE Hall of Famer, The Undertaker, he says Roman Reigns is walking out with a victory. Do y'all agree?
50-50, I'd say.
And again, again, this isn't just about retaining. This is about unifying.
Unifying.
That's the opportunity Roman Reigns has. I saw Roman earlier. I acknowledged him because I'm smart. I went up to him. I acknowledged him, and I asked him. I said, "Hey, what did you do? You enjoy Stone Cold?"
Yeah, no, hang on. You're not skipping past that. Go back a second. How did you acknowledge him?
Pretend I'm
Roman Reigns. Okay. It's the only time this will ever happen.
This is Roman Reigns, everybody.
Acknowledgement.
I just want you to know, sir, I acknowledge you. That's what I said to him. I looked him right in his eye and I said, I acknowledge you.
What do you think, Booker?
I hear like he's kissing.
You know what? I think you did the right thing.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's okay, the only way you survived that encounter.
Exactly.
Yeah,
I said to him, hey, did you get a chance to check out Stone Cold last night? He looked at me like I was insane. And he said, I don't watch anything else. I'm thinking about one thing. And that is tonight at Brock Lesnar. I'm not thinking about Stone Cold Steve Austin or anyone else. Yeah. Roman Reigns is in God mode, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, no, you go ahead, please.
No, I mean, I'm looking forward to this. I mean, I'm a big, big Roman Reigns fan. And I think about the list of Roman Reigns. There's been a lot of guys that has faced Roman Reigns and faced Roman Reigns, tried to climb that hill and could do it. And they say, I'm just going to get the hell out of this company. Okay, that's what Roman Reigns has done. I mean, retired Goldberg, I think, has a play. Roman Reigns is definitely a guy that's on another level. And I said it a long time ago, is Roman Reigns going to be able to fill the shoes of the legacy of the family bloodline? And I think so.
Well, we're gonna get a more in-depth discussion of this later on, but I want to talk to our two WWE Hall of Famers on the panel right now, because we just heard from a WWE Hall of Famer who's faced both of these gentlemen. Get into the head. How do you, I'd like to get into the head of The Undertaker and figure out why he chose Roman in this match over Brock Lesnar.
Well, I don't know if I can get into the head of The Undertaker.
That's a dangerous place to go.
Someplace I don't want to be, but right. You know, just watching that impressive video, Roman Reigns working out and hearing what he was saying. And one of the things that struck me when he said, the longer he goes, the stronger he gets. Well, that's all good, but you know what? Then I'm thinking back of all the matches that I watched Brock Lesnar in. And I sat there and I could not think of one time that I was watching a Brock Lesnar match and thought in my mind that Brock was tired.
But the one thing, Brock Lesnar, all of his matches are normally pretty quick. The one thing I think about this, Roman Reigns is not going to be able to, you know, outstrength Brock Lesnar. He's not going to be.
You don't think so?
No, I don't think he's going to be outstrength. I don't think he's going to be out wrestle Brock Lesnar. But from a cardio standpoint, an intestinal fortitude standpoint, I don't think there's anybody better than Roman Reigns. The tribal chief is going to step up tonight, and he's going to take the beast incarnate down. I can see it. I can feel it. Can you feel me? Can you feel me on this? I'm just saying, I could be wrong, but I don't think so.
You know, 580 days, guys. 580 days, King. He's been the Universal Champion. 6-time main eventing WrestleMania. And while all that's brilliant, and he's at the edge over Brock Lesnar the last two times they've met, this past few weeks on SmackDown, it's been Roman Reigns getting out of there while Brock Lesnar looks the more threatening.
Right.
Well, you know what? There's a lot of cliches about matches like this. And the one that comes to my mind, and really actually picture something like this happening. There's an unstoppable force flying across the universe. Nothing in the universe can stop it. It's unstoppable until it meets an immovable object. Something that can't be moved by anything. And that's what we have here. What is going to happen? I don't know
let me make one analogy real quick. You feel this, don't you? You feel what's happening. You feel that fear coming through.
Yeah.
And I have an analogy. Brock Lesnar, he's bad. He's a bad man. But Roman Reigns, he's like the wind. You can feel it, but you can't touch it. But you know it's there. That's the type of talent.
I love the analogy. Let's keep it going. Well, listen, like I said, we're going to continue breaking down this match a little later. I want to save some of this for then. But for those watching on Peacock Premium Plus, we want to take a closer look at Johnny Knoxville versus Sami Zayn. For those watching on Peacock or Peacock Premium, stick with us during the short break.